Our second referee, Virgilio Cruz Jr., national referee. And now let's feed the starters first for the Farm Fresh Foxies. Center number 7 from Adamson University, team captain Louis Romero. Outside spiker also from Adamson, number 4, Kate Santiago. Outside spiker from the University of the Philippines, number 5, Alisa Bertolano. Middle blocker from Adamson, number 8, Riza Cruz. Opposite hitter also from Adamson, number 12, Trisha Tubu. Middle blocker from Adamson, number 13, April Tagsin. Starting libero from the College of St. Benil, number 17, Jessa Torog. And the head coach for Farm Fresh is Jerry Yee. And now the starters for the PLDT High Speed Hitters. Middle blocker from De La Salle University, number 3, team captain Mika Reyes. Outside spiker from the University of Oklahoma, number 6, Savannah Davison. Opposite hitter from La Salle, number 10, Erica Santos. Center from the University of Santo Tomas, number 12, Rhea Dimaculagan. Middle blocker from the University of St. La Salle, number 13, Del Palomata. Outside spiker from the University of Perpetual Health System Delta, number 15, Royce Tubino. Starting libero from the University of the East, number 8, Kat Arado. And the head coach for PLDT is Rald Rickaport. This game is held under the supervision and regulation of the Games and Amusements Board. It is Farm Fresh versus PLDT. This is the PBL, the heart of volleyball.
And here are your starters. Start a new way to watch the PBL via the Pilipinas Live app for Filipinos everywhere. Download and subscribe now for 149 pesos. On your screen, starting lineup for the Farm Fresh Foxies. And we got Louis Romero, who is one of the standout rookies for this conference for Farm Fresh as well. She is also the team captain over on the side of PLDT. On your screens, the usual suspects. Pinag-usapan natin pa rin si Erica Santos, and she is starting today. And Del Palomata also had a big breakout game in that game that they played before this one. And so we are getting started here for our second of our triple header today. And the first game, if you missed it, was an exciting one. It was a sweep by F2. Against the next led. So nakikita na rin natin Paneng. Sabi nga, ito na, nakadaan na ng tagdadalawang games. Lahat ng kuponan dito. And Farm Fresh coming in to this game, still looking for a win.
Erica scores first.
Yeah, the first point going to PLDT courtesy of that opposite attack of Erica Santos. We talked about her during the pregame that she is actually one of the go-to scorers for their squad. And during their game against Akari, she scored 12 points. 4 of them actually scored double digits.
And the other one that we highlighted, and she is scoring first for Farm Fresh. You know, ang ganda ng sinabi mo kanina, Paneng, ano, na talaga nakakabilib na after 2 games, nalagpasan na niya yung performance niya from the first year of her professional career. And natawag dito. It's going to be a point given to PLDT. Somebody was at the net.
I think it was Riza Cruz, the middle blocker of the Farm Fresh Foxies. Our second referee saw that net touch violation.
Kate Santiago there with a up, and that is an unforced error there. Cruz still getting her bearings. It's early in the game. Farm Fresh with a point. PLDT leading by 2 early in this first set. bigat ng
Kate Santiago.
Bigat talaga ng dating ng mga palo ni Kate Santiago, and of course Louis Romero, Kate Santiago, they know each other well.
That's right. And actually, for that open attack, medyo nag-delay ng approach itong si Kate Santiago. Kung kailan pababa na yung blockers niya, dun niya pinalo yung bola.
Oh, that's a good up, good save. At Arado onto Louis Romero that time. Also good. We have a rally here. A slide. Erica Santos with a stop. And that is off the hands of Farm Fresh. Davidson taking advantage of the smaller blockers.
Farm Fresh side. This, the open attack of Savannah Davidson. Talagang targeting the hands of her blockers. And nakita mo yung direction ng katawan niya. Yung palo niya palabas ng court yung bola.
That's a good reception there by Farm Fresh. Tubu from the back row. Mambilis ng pace ng ating laro so far, Paneng.
That's right. And actually, coming off from a good one-hand defense of Kat Arado, nakagawa pa ng quick play dito si Rhea de Maculangan and si Del Palomata. Take a look at that.
That looks good. And let's talk a little bit about D-Mac, who also had a huge game last time out because talagang napa-andar niya, na-activate niya lahat ng mga offensive players, yeah. She was able to accomplish to get four of her players in double digits in that last game out.
Yeah, it was Savannah Davidson, Erica Santos, Del Palomata, and Royce Tubino. Those are the four players who scored double digits during their game against Akari.
And this is our first ace. They also had a lot of aces in that game against Akari, eight in total. And Davidson scores the first ace for the team. Davidson pretty dangerous also. As we know, Paneng, 19 points at last game. Three-setter lang. Pag-set, maikli yung mga game, pero nakaka-score sila.
Mm-hmm. And actually, parang naka-adjust na to si Savannah sa high-speed hitters. Yung first game nila, medyo mabagal pa yung naging laro niya, but definitely naging okay na nung second game.
Ganda nung attitude ni Savvy. How can I help? Sabi niya, yun ang kanyang mindset pagdating sa loob ng high school. Meantime, we have Alexis Tinsay ready for her first report. Ay?
Chiki and Paneng, Savvy Davidson of the PLDT High Speed Hitters. I heard that you were talking about her. Actually shared to me that this sport, volleyball, can be played in all countries with the same rules. But what makes it different here in the Philippines is the people and the culture that makes it colorful. PLDT is quite an empathetic team, according to her. And that Savvy is actually not quite used to. Dahil mas stricto at seryoso ang teammates niya abroad. At dito naman, mahinay at maalaga ang teammates. Yeah, no language barrier here because she understands Tagalog. Pero hindi daw siya sanay na imbis na sumigaw ng mine for the ball. Dito sa PVL, ako. And with her best interest at heart for her teammates, Savvy feels at home. So speaking of feeling at home, you can actually watch anywhere with Pilipinas Live app for 149 pesos available everywhere in the world. Back to you, Chiki and Paneng.
Thanks so much for that, Ai. Interesting to see the dynamics in the PLDT squad and what it's like to train with them during summer. Nakatuwa. PLDT already pulling away here, Paneng.
Yeah, 6-point advantage for the high-speed hitters. If you take a look at the Farm Fresh Foxes, medyo tahimik yung body language na since the start of this game. So they need to communicate more and be more aggressive to get more points as well.
Just a Tubu with aggression there, but good blocking from PLDT. And that joust won by Liza Bertolano.
That was a good one-on-one block there by Bertolano. Timing that drop ball of Erica Santos perfectly, getting their fifth point.
Interesting also to see the contrast here. We're looking at recent UAAP stars all in one team in the young Farm Fresh team. Sa kabila naman, yung mga veterano na matagal na naglalaro. So it's veterans against the new breed in this matchup.
Oh,
and that one got through. Ika Reyes and Taksip will score for Farm Fresh and get the ball back. Farm Fresh, of course, needing to string along some points here. Kailangan sila makahabol. That's a good serve. Good reception by PLDT. Able blocking here by the Foxies. Play continues. PLDT back with the ball. Davison going up. Good stop by Tagsit. Tubu. And again, the advantage of being a lefty, si Tubu on the opposite side, no, mas kontrolado niya talaga pag nasa kanan.
Right, and actually that was a high set, pero hindi naka-approach ng malayo itong si Trisha Tubu. But nagawan pa niya ng paraan yung attack niya, targeting zone 1 of PLDT's defense.
It's a good stop by Kat Arado there on the reception. Davison with a roll. Romero looking for Kate Santiago. Good stop by D-Mac. Davison again taking it slow. Tubu blocked. Tubu going up again and she goes across court. Gandang puto ni D-Mac dun. Kate Santiago this time is blocked. This is the best rally we've seen between these two teams so far in this match. Play goes on. Kate Santiago goes up again. And this time, Ika Reyes succeeds with her blocking there. Gandang rally.
Yeah, and actually that was a long rally and you have to give credit to the defense of both squads. But during that last sequence, talagang pinatibay nitong PLDT yung blocking nila. Kaya sila nakakuha ng puntos doon. Hindi na nakakuha ng coverage dito ang Farm Fresh Foxies.
I'm sure Paneng tinitingnan nito ni Coach Jerry and that last sequence, kahit na natalo pa rin sila, nakuha pa rin ng PLDT yung puntos, I'm sure he was happy about how the girls handled that rally.
Mm-hmm. Walang huminto sa kanila. Talagang kinocover nila yung mga attackers nila and nababasa nila ng maayos yung atake na pinapakawala ng PLDT.
That was a quick point down the line by King Santiago. Good read there by Eliza. Bertolano and Tubu goes deep now. Zone 6.
Targeting the long ball there, the defense of PLDT. Nagka-miscommunication na doon si Arado and si Royce Tubino. Who will get that long ball?
Points in a row for Farm Fresh. Let's see if they can continue this streak. Underhanded set, and that one is outside, untouched. Another point for Farm Fresh. Ito yung hinihingi mo, sabi mong they need to shake things up.
That's right. Don't look now. 2 points na lang yung damang nitong PLDT. Kanina nabanggit natin na 6-point advantage ang meron sila. But slowly, nakakakuha ng puntos itong Farm Fresh Foxies.
Oh, good stop there. Good stop on both sides. The libero showing off. That one escapes Bertolano. And Davison with her wrath again. And she scores her third point. And PLDT's 13th. And we have a timeout.
And we have Ai Vinsai also on the sidelines doing the reporting.
And this is still a three-point deficit for Farm Fresh, but you are liking what you're seeing so far, Paneng.
Yeah, like what I mentioned kanina, slow start itong Farm Fresh Foxies. They were not communicating much inside the court, but parang kahit tahimik sila, nagkakaintindihan sila, no? Na slowly dumidikit yung score nila dito sa lamang ng PLDT. And PLDT naman on the other hand, parang they're just waiting for the Foxies to commit an error for them to score a point. So that shouldn't be the case, because if you want to have more points, you should be the one forcing your opponents, right, to commit an error. But this time, very good game that we're seeing here from the Foxies.
We got Kate Santiago again. Kate Santiago going down the line there. Another lefty plays on the left side. Lefty outside hitter, medyo mahirap din maspelling. Davison, baon na baon naman.
You have to give credit to the good approach in the middle ni Del Palomata. Take a look at that timing with the set of Freya. Nakakuha siya ng dalawang blockers doon. Kaya naman na-late na sa middle block dito si Cruz, only leaving their setter Romero to block for the Savannah's attack.
Back row attack. That one's a little too strong. Konting bawas pa, siguro. Galing kay Trisha Tubu. Leads back to four for the high-speed hitters in our first set. Tubu going from back row again. Royce Tubino still finding the line there. Going deep in the court of Farm Fresh, and that's 16-11 now. 5-point lead for PLDT.
Good open attack there by Royce Tubino. Yung defense ng Foxes, akala nila it will sail out, but biglang bumagsak dun sa dulo ng zone 5 ng defense nila.
That's a tough one. Good serve there. PLDT will set up. Back row, Davison. And really challenging.
Savannah Davison.
The libero of Farm Fresh. See, Jess Adoro, she's had a couple of good stops there already. This time a little too much, and medyo tutuloy-tuloy itong si Savvy Davison at the service line. That's a chance ball here for PLDT. Good save by Savvy. And that one is definitely inside. And that is a string of points that we're seeing already for PLDT. Tubino's third.
This is the first challenge for this set. Coach Jerry would like to challenge that Royce Tubino attack, whether it is ball in or ball out. We're too far from that angle, so we didn't see much if it was really inside. The first referee was closer to that line, and he saw it.
Also a strategic decision, I think, for Coach Jerry to kind of break the momentum, which is definitely on the side of PLDT. The breakaway na sila. Though Farm Fresh, as we see, is holding their own against this veteran team. And sabi mo nga pa na yung kailangan lang siguro increase yung intensity.
Yeah. Sa ngayon, hindi pa natin nakikita yung intensity na yon ng Foxies. Kahit na nakaka-score sila, medyo tahimik pa rin sila when they celebrate.
Nakakatuwa rin isipin kasi individually, they're really very talented. And kita natin din yung gelling at yung chemistry na nandyan si Louie Romero, Kate Santiago, Trisha Tubu. Parang nararamdaman mo na talagang kilalang-kilala na nila yung isa't isa. And that really works well for them. So they should take advantage of that.
Yeah, that's right. But on the other side naman, the side of the PLDT high-speed hitters, sila naman puro veterano. Ang tagal na nilang magkakasama, how many conferences na. So every conference, we're seeing improvements naman on their squad. Lalo na ngayon, they have Savannah Davison in their lineup.
And yun, na-highlight mo rin yun, Paneng, na como ang tatagal na nga nito magkakasama, pinasok si Davison at parang hindi siya naiiba, no?
Oo. Parang ang tagal na niya kasama yung squad.
And that's really credit to her and the way she approaches her game. Na talagang role player siya. She's there to do what she is asked, and she has delivered so far. Kita-kita may athleticism niya. Officials taking their time here with this ball-in, ball-out challenge. The first that we've seen in this first set. Looking at the standings, of course, Farm Fresh, napanggit mo rin that they have been looking for a win since the last conference. So that's 7 in a row already. An inconclusive challenge. It's the first time I've seen that, actually.
So the point will stay with the PLDT squad.
Let's see if that will break the momentum here. No, that actually resulted in an ace from Savannah Davidson. Ganun siya ka-professional. Kahit na subukan mong i-distract siya, break the momentum to ice her.
That was a slow ball na halang for the receive, pero no one attempted to get that ball. Back-to-back service ace for Savannah Davidson.
And she's just scoring every which way. She already has 7 points, Abby Davidson. 3 from aces. Recalling their performance against Akari the last time out, their last match, the team had 8 aces. And Del Palomata sitting out now. And we
We also have a substitute on the side of Farm Fresh Foxies. Ildefonso is now inside the court, subbing in for Bertolano.
And she did it. That's a good reception. And she went up for the hit and scores right away. Pia Ildefonso. Gandang magic kunot. Of course, Pia Ildefonso, one of the taller players. So it's good to kailangan balansehin kasi si Louis Romero. Siyempre, tinatarget siya pagka nasa harap as a smaller blocker.
Rachel Astero.
Astero now hitting it off the hands of Pia Ildefonso to score point number 21 for PLDT. Good serve. This is going to be a broken play. Oh, not even. Doro couldn't even get it across the net. And that's considered an ace. Another one for PLDT. 10-point lead.
Timeout for Fresh.
We have a timeout.
Wala pang ginagawa yung kalaban nyo, wala tayong pasok. Ha? Galaw pa, galaw pa. First one tayo.
Sige, lang, buhay lang sa loob. Buhay
natin sa
loob. Go back, ha?
Go, left, go, left, go, left.
PLDT number 3, Reyes out. Number
18, Jesse. Desperation time really here for Farm Fresh. I mean, what do you do when you're going up against a veteran team like PLDT? He's enjoying a 10-point lead already. I think it's going to be a do-over. Hindi pa yata handa.
I think there was no whistle yet.
Ostero coming off the bench. She's serving. And that looks good. So it's been a good connection here between Romero and Pia Ildefonso. That's 2 for 2 for her on her attacks.
Right, and actually that was a good first ball also from Kate Santiago. Sakto-sakto lang kay Romero. She was able to time her set sa quick attack but setting it sa open kay Ildefonso.
And that's a dink. Good read there by the blockers of PLDT. Jesse De Leon is on the court now for the high-speed hitters. Ron Fresh putting up a fight here. We have good defense from PLDT. Here's another chance for the Foxies. Oh, that looked good.
April Taksip.
That was just what the doctor ordered. Taksip with a good one.
It was a zero tempo quick attack there by Taksip. good connection with her and their setter, Louie Romero.
Chance again for the Farm Fresh Foxies to score. Good stop there by Davison. Royce Tubino is stopped by Kate Santiago this time. PL Defonso again. Davison just working hard on defense. Nakita natin, all-around player talaga to si Savvy.
Parang dalawa na yung libero sa likod ngayon.
Tama.
PLDT whenever she's in the back row.
But Farm Fresh will come away with that point. And they are just hanging on. Nakita natin ang tibay ng Farm Fresh. Hindi sila bumibigay. Romero with a service ace. Tumahabol ang Farm Fresh. That's 5 points they made up. Or rather, 4 points. Napapos sa 22 ang PLDT.
16 serving 22.
Coach Ral substituted Ceballos for Davison.
Royce Tubino.
Royce Tubino. Just powering it through. That's her fourth point. Point number 23. PLDT, we know Dima can be dangerous at the serve.
One of the better servers for the PLDT squad.
That's a good one. Good up there by Dorog.
Trisha Tubu.
Conversion, Trisha Tubu comes through. Farm Fresh stays alive here. Tia Ildefonso of the famed Ildefonso clan. Now at the serve, she has done well so far, scoring 2 points in 3 attempts. Tubu again, but PLDT keeps it alive. Good save there by Ildefonso. Kate Santiago going up, kinaliwa. Royce Tubino timing it. Lasso hinabol, and this is going to be a free ball. Chance here again for PLDT to put it away.
Oh, good
Atienz and Lasso. And this time, Royce Tubino says enough is enough. That was another good rally, Paneng.
Yeah, ang ganda ng depensahan itong Farm Fresh Foxies. But for that last point, Royce Tubino targeting in between her blockers. Ang laki ng butas na yun sa blocking ni Tagsip and ni Trisha Tubu.
Jusa Monte on the court. So that's a late substitution. And also Fiol Ceballos, as you said, also coming in late in this first set. For the finisher, let's see if Ceballos does it. And she is able to score the winning point. Coming off the bench here, 25-17 is how that first set ends. We appreciate and we really see that Farm Fresh tried their best and nakahabol naman talaga. Marami silang napuntos at a very crucial time. But still, PLDT was constant. on the panel. Set one had a lot of high points for Farm Fresh, pero kinulang and naubusan ang oras.
Yes, and actually, if they started early, maganda yung start nila for that set. Mas makakadikit pa yung points nila because I kept on mentioning that they started really quiet and slow. They had a 6-point deficit and very relaxed naman itong laro ng PLDT High Speed Hitters. But nung mid, kalagitnaan ng first set hanggang sa panapos, no, tumidikit itong Farm Fresh Foxes because they had a good defense. Good floor defense, but yung blocking sila, dun din nakakuha ng puntos itong PLDT. Basic volleyball lang for PLDT, and we're looking at the statistics. Attack points, PLDT had 14 against 12 ng Farm Fresh Foxes. One block point and four service aces for PLDT. But take a look at their errors. Hindi rin naman siya nakakalayo because Farm Fresh had 6 errors while PLDT had 4. But going back to that first set, Foxes had a good floor defense. But mas naging aggressive when it comes to attacking itong PLDT. And definitely, yung defense nila, they always cover their attackers. And palagi silang may sagot na set play or... We didn't see any combination plays from PLDT side. But puro open attacks or quick plays na dun na nahihirapan yung blockers nitong Foxes.
Nakita natin na talagang... ang dala ni Davison to the front and the back so much valuable for the team because even as a defensive player, sabi mo nga parang dalawa yung libero nila at all times. Sa kabila naman, Farm Fresh actually does have two liberos who are alternating, both of them doing well, but they really have to step up with their service reception dahil nga the aces coming from PLDT side.
Yun na, hindi sila makakuha ng magandang palo talking about the Farm Fresh Foxes because wala sila masyadong aggressive next to first ball. Yeah, during the timeout, narinig din natin mga coaches ng Foxes always reminding the players to start with a good first ball because without receive, wala silang set play. Madaling mababasa ng depensa ng PLDT yung atake nila.
We saw Davison there with a kill to start things off here in the second set. PLDT scoring first. Good block by Kate Santiago. Balasa uli ang PLDT. And down the line, Erica Santos was quiet in the first set, Paneng. But here she comes.
2-0 PLDT.
Royce Tubino now continuing to serve. She has also been alive and has contributed 5 points already to the PLDT. High-speed hitters. Narinig ko yung bolang yun. I'm sure narinig nyo rin sa inyong mga TV set. Ang lakas ng balo ni Kate.
Yes, and actually this is a different lineup for Coach Jerry for second set ditong Foxes using Cloan Mondenedo as their setter and bringing in Jasmine Pascual as their open attacker.
And Joanne Narit also seeing action for the first time here for the Farm Fresh Foxes. So she's a talented middle blocker now from the Ateneo squad. Young blood talaga showing off here in Farm Fresh.
And also Justin Dorog, open attacker for Foxes, is inside the court.
And that one is off the hands of Pascual. And kita mo yan yung talagang the veteran moves, experience lang. Tapikin mo lang nga. Just hit it off the hands.
Yeah, kasi medyo malayo na sa kanya yung bola. And nakita niya yung kamay ni Jasmine Pascual doon. So easy point.
That's Davison's 9th point already. That one is going to be 4. Farm Fresh.
Yeah, there was a check ball. I think the blockers on the side for PLDT was Del Palomata and Erica Santos.
Parang platoon substitution itong ginawa ni Coach Jerry, no? Talagang different look here in the second set for Farm Fresh. Let's see if that pans out for them.
Yeah, si Kate Santiago lang yung naiwan inside the court.
5-7-2. Now serving Erica Santos.
Erica Santos looking for her target. Santiago with a good reception. Ang gandang bantay naman ni Del Palomata. And of course, Iria de Maculangan, one of the tallest setters we have. So she's an asset. Even, you know, she's in front.
That was a good read on the block by Del Palamata. But after, if you take a look at that, medyo mababa din yung set ni Johan, the center of Foxy's, for that quick attack.
That's a good idea for Mondo Niedo to go the other way. That was an unexpected hit from the right-hand side by Pascual.
Now serving Gail Pascual.
Quick. Palomata had so many of those against Akari the last time out.
And if you saw that quick attack of Palomata, nakaharap siya cross-court, pero yung palo niya going zone one or on the other side. Kaya ang hirap blockin yun. Dahil siyempre as a blocker, tatapatan mo yung braso ng spiker mo or kung saan siya nakaharap.
So siguro pinapractice din ni Del yun, ano? How to deceive your blocker. Meantime, Alexis Tidsay is ready with her report. Go, Ayi.
Chiki and Paneng, I actually wanted to talk to you guys about the premier matchup you actually featured a while ago, Trisha Tubu and Erica Santos. Farm Fresh Foxy Trisha Tubu actually is contributing double digits to the game while actually finishing her defense. Fresh from her defense, in her thesis last Sunday, Trisha is currently taking IT in Adamson right now. Talk about beauty, brains, and athletic ability. Erica Santos, on the other hand, is ecstatic to start for PLDT, given she shared to me that she had an up and down season last conference. With that, Erica hopes to take care of the trust given by Coach Rald by continuing her fiery presence on court. And speaking of this match, we can relive it by downloading the Pilipinas Live app for 149 pesos available everywhere in the world. Let's go back to the panel.
Thanks so much, Ayi. Interesting there. Tamaka, it's all about trust that Coach Rob is giving Erica. She's getting a lot of playing time here, of course, because she did so well in the last game. Pero gusto ko yung defense ni Trisha Tubo. Nakakabilib naman itong si Trisha. Ay, talagang a very busy student taking her studies seriously and still, of course, doing her job. This is a job. She's in the pros.
Definitely. And it's so hard to balance studies and volleyball, but credit to all of the student athletes dahil you really have to focus first on your studies before playing. Just happy din ng aming mga university coaches na you're a student first.
And you're right, you know, we have student athletes both in the collegiate level and in the pro level. Kate Santiago is dug there by Kat Arado. And oh, Boris Tubino, the off speed, that worked out.
Yeah, and actually, nakita na nung depensa ng Foxy's yun. Nagsigawan na sila na, but who will get that drop ball? Because it landed right in between the defense of Farm Fresh Foxy's. Tatlo na yung nakadepensa doon. Tatlo na yung nag-expect na is a short ball yun or drop ball, but no one really attempted to get it.
Misread there by Joan Narit, or that was a good offensive play by the blockers of PLDT. Whichever way you want to see it, it's a point for the high-speed hitters. The defense of Farm Fresh cannot be tentative like you described, Paneng. Lalo na nagahabol sila. That break here. Very few service errors from both sides. Ha? Parang una pa lang yata yun, or pangalawa, may isang mahaba.
Serving for Farm Fresh, Chloe Mondoniego.
That's Jovi Prado from the PLDT squad, supporting her teammates.
And Erica Santos scores again, nice and easy. That's third point for Santos.
That was a tough set from DMAC. Paatras siya. Yeah, medyo malayo na siya on the right side, pero she was still able to set that ball in the middle for Erica Santos. Clearly a veteran setter.
Good defense from Royce Tubino there.
Oh,
that one gets
Erica Santos.
Lazo there. And then a half ball. We have PLDT at 13 points, taking us to our first technical timeout. Back for more after the break. Philippines. And we are back for more of your Tuesday volleyball here at your PVL. This is our second All-Filipino Conference this year. Had a lot of great volleyball in 2023. Ito patapos na. And for those of you just joining the action here at the Inada Center, it was a three-set victory by F2 against that Next Led earlier today. And so far, Farm Fresh tried but could not keep up with PLDT in that first set. So it was a 25-17 set number one with PLDT taking that one handily. And still, naghahanap pa rin ng lamang ang Farm Fresh. They have not been able to lead here in the second set.
Serving for PLDT, Royce Tumino.
Seven points already for Royce Tumino. Santiago.
Kate Santiago.
Mapakanan, mapakaliwa, yeah. No, paning.
And it was actually a good target for Kate Santiago, targeting down the line of PLDT defense. Nakita, humahabol lang sa blocking si Savannah and si Mika. So that was a smart attack there for Kate.
Mika!
But that's also a smart push from Mika Reyes. She saw that medyo yung defense ng Foxes nakasagad sa harap.
No one
was there to get the long ball.
Utaka na lang for Mika Reyes. That's her second point today. That's a good floater serve there. Kate Santiago makes do. D-Mac looking for Davison. Good read there by Mondoniedo. Quick by Del Palomata. We saw that one coming. Oh, good try there, but Narit was just not in the position to save that ball.
Since the first set, nahihirapan makakuha ng block in defense itong Foxy sa mga quick attacks ng PLDT. So far, hindi pa siya masyadong inactivate ni Rhea. Parang paminsan-minsan niya binibigyan ng mga quick attacks ng kanyang mga middle attackers, mostly mga wing spikers.
And that's what we appreciate most about D-Mac, really, the way she's able to distribute the ball and activate all of her players. And that's a lucky break for Farm Fresh with that long serve from Jessie De Leon.
9 serving 15.
But still a 6-point deficit.
Joanne Garrett.
They had a run around this time, mid game in the first set. So Farm Fresh, you know, is capable of that.
Yeah, but this moment, mag-commit sila ng mga service errors or any unforced errors, whenever the momentum is on their side, will not help their squad. Yeah. Because they, as much as possible, they want to score more points para makadikit sa score nitong PLDT, like what they did during the first set.
Pascual,
game 4
there. It's right in front of us here, Paneng. Ang ganda ng approach niya. Talagang tusok.
Cross-court attack there by Pascual. And now Coach Jerry will have a double substitution, bringing in Louie Romero.
And Captain Louie Romero in.
To have a 3 frontline attackers for this rotation.
Louie Romero.
Almost an ace there. And a great stop by Kat Arado in the back. Davison is stopped this time by Lazo. Tubu.
Oh.
Welcome back, Tubu. Kasi ngayon lang siya linaro for the second set, ano?
Ayun naman, nakakuha kagad ng puntos itong si Trisha Tubu, targeting the hands of Del Palomata. Kaya naman, ang hirap depensa niyo in between and Erica Santos.
We also have Nolasco, who is seeing action for the first time here in the second set. She was brought in a little bit earlier. One of the tallest players here in Farm Fresh. Great stop. But an
that's
even better two-man block there. Palomata Davison joining forces. More time on that play. Kasi tumayo.
Yeah, I was gonna say, ang taas ng talon ni Savannah Davison. Parang magpantay na yung kamay nila ni Del Palomata on the clock.
Siyempre si Del, 6-3, di ba? Tapos ganyang kataas yung talo ni Davison. And Mepito, and that is a break here for Farmfresh. Double contact called against PLDT. They should take advantage of these mga free points.
12 serving 17.
Now they should have a good service and focus on their blocking.
Dorog had a couple of really good stops. Parang na-master na talaga ni Del Palomata itong mga quicks niya. She's from all over the place.
Yeah, and this is the first time that we've seen her do a short running attack. Parang sikip na ng area nila doon ni Rhea and ni Del, but she was still able to do that short running, targeting down the line or zone 5 defense of the Foxies.
That's a good reception, something that we should see more of from the Foxies, and an unforced error. Unfortunately, Tubu just hits that wide.
19, serving 12.
PLDT looking good here in the second set. Things just are going pretty smoothly on the side of the high-speed hitters. That's a good pass. And hindi mo pa next. Starts with that good pass.
Yes, definitely a good first ball and a good connection between Romero and Kate Santiago. Take a look at this. Hindi na nakahabol si Jesse De Leon for the block. And of course, if you're the spiker, nakikita mo na late na yung middle blocker mo. So target cross-court, a smart attack there by Kate.
A perfect shoot set from Romero. And this time, she goes back set to Tubu. Nabasa ng PLDT. Pasok!
It's inside!
Well, hindi madalas nakaka-score ang libero.
Yeah, but lucky break there for Kat Arado. And actually, a smart push. Kasi hinabol na lang niya. Alam niya, hindi na niya matataas yung bola. So might as well just send it over and target the long ball.
Right at the corner. Serving 13. 7-point lead for PLDT. They took the first set, 25-17. Nice combination attack. Naghahanap ka kanina pa rin.
Yes, and right on cue, combination attack there. Pero daming spikers on that side. Three of the spikers are on left side of the Fox. Hindi pa rin nakita yun ang blockers ng PLDT. Smart play there by Romero.
Here's another chance. Oh, this time she tried to sneak one past Kat Arado. A save. Ball still good. Oh! A little lapse there for Dorog, and she knew it.
Yeah. Parang medyo nag-hesitate din siya doon for that back row attack. But good intention though, na soft lang. But it was too soft. But maybe kasi ang taas ng dating ng bola sa kanya coming from that save ni Louie Romero.
Good effort there by Farmfresh. PLDT still poised to taking the second set. Not unless Farmfresh is able to string along some points. Kate Santiago has almost been flawless with her down-the-line hits from the left side.
15,
so far, hindi pa nabablock itong si Kate Santiago. Ang daming daan ng bola niya. So either cross-court or down-the-line.
And she's been known to really work on her angles. Again, it's ano, kasi parang orthodox sa kaliwete yung outside.
Drew Samonte
scoring here off the bench for PLDT.
Now serving Jesse De Leon.
Seeing the shuffling that Coach Schrald is doing, and we haven't even seen like the likes of Mitch Morente on the court. Talagang ang lalim ng bench talaga ng PLDT. Well, that one escapes Jesse De Leon.
Justine Dorog.
Farmfresh taking things one point at a 16, time, but I don't know if that would be enough at this juncture. Paning.
Yeah, PLDT needs 3 points to close this set. So far, malayo pa ang kailangang habulin itong Foxies.
Davison with a roll again. Knows when to do what. Ang ganda nung ano, yung kanyang choice of hits, yung kanyang repertoire. napakadami, napakalawak.
Yeah, papa. Strong attack na cross court using the hands of her blockers or kahit drop ball lang in between the defense of their opponents. But for Farmfresh Foxies naman, minsan nakikita mo na eh. Alam na nila, nababasa na nila kung anong gagawin ng attackers ng PLDT. But hindi ganun ka-aggressive yung attempts nila for defense.
Savannah Davison!
And again, Savannah Davison with her smarts. Siyempre, dadaan niya sa kamay ni Louie Romero.
Serving for the set, Jules Samonte.
First set ended 25-17 and we are at set point once again here in set number two, Jules Samonte. That's a good reception. Ball back in the court of Farmfresh. Dorog stopped there by Arado. And that one is beyond the antenna. So that's going to be a point for Farmfresh holding PLDT.
17 set point. Now serving Louie Romero. Substitution.
Davison steps out for Ceballos.
Davison out. Number 17, Fiola Ceballos in.
Okay, isipin mo rin, di ba? Si Fiola Ceballos is such a dependable player and now she is just backup ni Davison. Ganun talaga kalakas ang PLDT ngayon.
During the previous conference, she was one of the top scorers also for their squad. That was outside.
That's outside. Trisha Tubuhad, good intentions, but that one got escaped her. And that service, that error by Trisha Tubu gave PLDT their winning point. So identical scores for the first and second set, 25-17. PLDT having quite an easy time here against the Farmfresh Foxies. And the team of newbies, these the young bloods, have one more set to try to score a win here. We'll take a break. Back in a moment. Seven-day losing streak going back to the conference before this one. And medyo hinahanap mo sila paneng ng konti pang intensity and more energy and commitment.
Yes, and yeah, for the first two sets, hindi pa rin natin nakikita yung intensity na yon coming from the Farmfresh Foxies. they're really quiet while playing. And though, nabanggit ko kanina na alam nila yung gagawin ng attackers nila, but that push and the defense, dun nakukulangan yung side nila. Hindi masyado nakakuha ng transition plays itong Farm Fresh Foxies. But on the side of the PLDT high speed hitters naman, very relaxed volleyball lang sila. Their focus on their defense, net defense, and also yung service. They got a couple. They didn't get any service ace for that set. Now we're looking at the statistics. Sa attack na dominate nila, talking about PLDT, yung Farm Fresh, they had 15 points against 11 ng Farm Fresh Foxies. 2 block points ng PLDT, no service ace, and they had less errors for that set. They only had 5 errors against 8 ng Foxies. Like what I mentioned, ang ganda ng depensa nitong PLDT high-speed hitters. Net defense, nababasa nila yung spikers ng Foxies. Nakakuha sila ng block points, but as much as possible, kahit hindi ganun kadami yung block points nila, nache-check nila yung attacker sila. Kaya nagiging madali yung floor defense ng PLDT. Hence, closing that second set. Same score lang ng first set, 25-17.
No? Pero at least nakita nga natin wala nang service aces on the side of PLDT. So nag-improve ang reception ng Farm Fresh. And kung matuloy-tuloy lang nila yon, if they can convert these good passes. And we also saw na medyo nagbalasa si Coach Jerry dun sa ating second set. Na iba yung pinasok niya na 6, no? Na 6, si Kate Santiago na natira. And then midway, medyo binalik niya unti-unti yung first 6.
Double substitution si Romero and si Trisha Tubu. But this time, third set, bago na naman itong lineup ni Coach Jerry.
We're seeing him start... Let's see, Pia Ildefonso is already on the court. She came in towards the latter part of the first set. And she has been effective. Naka 2 points agad siya. And we are seeing Romero back on the court as well with her
I think parang first set. Parang ito yung first set lineup ni Coach Jerry. Pero pinasok niya si Pia Ildefonso rather than Eliza Bertolano.
Right. Who has actually not been back on the court since that first set. Wow. Oh, ganun ba? Ganun magsimula ng set. Just a kill there. So nice to watch, actually. So much excitement that this girl brings to the court. Grabe naman yung talo na yun.
Grabe yung elevation. She got a good first ball and she was able to get that approach. And parang pasugod sa net yung approach. Ang taas ng talon and targeting zone 1 dahil si Romero yung blocker na doon. So she's not that tall for the blocking zone 1.
To see Davison, just the energy she brings in, it's palpable. I'm sure nararamdaman nyo rin yan just watching her on your TV screens. What more yung mga nanonood dito live? And this is what we're going to be enjoying for the rest of this second All-Filipino Conference from this Phil-Canadian. What an exciting, explosive player. Savvy Davison.
Oh, of course, quick attack dito ni Del Palomata. I mentioned it a while ago na hindi na didepensahan yung mga quick attack nito ni Del. Dahil ang taas ng reach niya and may times din na iniiba niya yung direction ng atake niya kaya nahihirapan yung blockers.
Hirap basahin talaga. Ildefonso, block there. Another chance here. Oh, Kate Santiago sends the ball back to PLDT. Davison, stopped by Kate. Gandang habol ng Farm Fresh. Chance ball. Dimac going for Savvy and we know what she wanted to do. Lucky for Farm Fresh, medyo... masyadong malakas.
Oh, that sails out.
One serving three.
Pero basang-basa ni Savvy, nakita niya everybody was parang coached up front. Walang natira dun sa likod, butas na butas. Swerte na lang talaga ng Farm Fresh, napalakas yung palo ni Savvy Davison.
So far, the leading scorer for PLDT, itong si Savvy Davison with 14 points. But on the side of Farm Fresh Foxies naman, si Kate Santiago with 8 points.
15 already for Davison after that last play. She scored 19 in her last game and in a 3-setter.
And now she's already at 15.
Yeah.
Naka-start pa lang ng third set.
And that one is the blockers. Another point for Pia Ildefonso. Already with 3 today. And Trisha Tubu with 6 points today. Santiago, as you mentioned, Paneng, the highest score so far for Farm Fresh. Lee Romero looking for PL Defonso. Good stop by Kat Arado there. Davison, point number 16 for Savannah Davison. She goes cross-court this time. Pinapakita lang niya lahat yung everything in her arsenal.
Yeah. Ang dami-daan ng bola niya, right? Ang lakas din. Pag naiwan mo, bukas talaga yung blocking mo. Ititigin niya yung palo niya.
Para siyang ano, para siyang ways. Kung may traffic dun sa kanan, i-re-reroute niya, idadaan niya dun sa kaliwa. Oh, wow. What a block, but what a save by Kat Arado. That one escapes Defonso. And another point for Royce Tubino, her eighth. And PLDT up by four. Lexis Tensai is ready with her report. Ai?
Chiki and Paneng, another player that you've highlighted a while ago is Kate Santiago. And I loved her take on the lead because she told me a young team may not have much expectations on their side, but their dreams and their goals are to the fullest. Given the young guns being together last conference and this one, Coach Jerry told them that with all the lessons they've learned and built along the way, their foundation and core will be unstoppable in season's time. It's not just the skills they're training for, but the accountability and maturity on their end, because again, this is the Pro League already. Excited that this league is now a round robin. Makakalaro na daw nila ang mga idol nila from all the other veteran teams. And speaking of reliving this match's excitement, download the Pilipinas Live app now for only 149 pesos. Back to you, Chiki and Paneng.
Thanks a lot, Ai, who is looking so good these days. Talagang blooming ito si Alexis Tidsai. And ang ganda nung sabi niya, no? It's for these young players, it's really all about the privilege of playing against their idols. That must mean something for them.
Yeah, and actually parang hindi itong talking about Kate Santiago, parang hindi siya beginner. Kung bang laro, right? Nakakasabay siya sa mga ates niya, sa mga idols din. And she's actually one of the steady receivers for the Foxies.
Yeah, just watch out for Kate Santiago. Through the years, she's going to be a force to reckon with.
April Taksip.
And Taksip there, sneaking in a point. That's her third today, using her height. Exactly. Talagang challenge si Del Palamaca.
Uh-oh, laki ng blocker niya. But why not? Kaya naman niya, right?
That must feel good for Taksip.
Good first ball.
Perfect first ball there. Good defense by Farm Fresh. And that solo block by Royce. The offensive block kasi bumalik dun sa likod na wala talagang tao.
Yeah, because everyone was expecting for a short ball coverage, right? Walang naiwan sa likod.
Nalalasap mo ba yung sarap ng offensive block?
Paneng. Yeah. Lalo pag mag-isa ka lang.
Kate Santiago. Monster hit.
Kate Santiago!
That's point number 9. Chasing a double-digit performance. Santiago is really showing her aggression this third set. Like you said, she should, no, Paneng?
And very consistent siya since the start of this game. She's really helping the team with good first balls. And yung mga atake niya, mapa-open man or opposite. Dami na kuhang puntos.
Meantime, Mika Reyes, we've seen her just using her smarts instead. Pushing the ball in. And scoring the easiest of ways. 3 points for Mika Reyes. Oh, that's a good pass there. There you go. That's what I want to see more of.
Yeah, that was a nice combination play. Nakita mo, parang tatlo na yung blockers ng PLDT yung tumalon. Take a look at this. So that was a good approach ni Pascual, the middle blocker, middle attacker of Foxies. Good connection sila doon ni Romero. Pero sinet niya kay Trisha Tubu for that combination.
Ganun decoy, no? And we saw that identical play in the second set. So it starts with that perfect, started with that perfect pass by Bartolano. Good save by Kate Santiago. And that one is outside. Santos looking for a touch. He's not going to get it. And Farm Fresh still at the tails of PLDT, but not too far behind. Just a three-point deficit.
Kate Santiago.
Ito, talk about commitment. Ito si Kate Santiago is all in.
That touch?
That touch called on Bertolano.
That's unfortunate, no? Yung makakapunos yung kalaban mo on...
Yan yung mga enforced errors. Itong toxic. Every time na nasa kanila yung momentum, nagkukumit sila ng errors.
So they just need to clean up a little. And Icarus using the help of the net for that ace. Five already for Mika. Good reception. Bertolano will go up.
Oh,
short.
Eliza Bertolano.
Off-speed spike working out for Eliza Bertolano. That's her second point today.
8-7-12.
Si Bertolano, we also remember when she first made waves in the UAAP. One of the star players of UP, rather. Talagang very athletic siya. So we want to see her explode here in the pros.
Erica Santos.
Santos gets the better of Bertolano that time, though.
The technical timeout score, PLDT 13.
And you've got your 5-point lead for PLDT in this third. On One Sports, One Sports Plus, and Pilipinas Live. But let's stick to the game at hand. The women's volleyball, the heart of volleyball, the PBL, in our second All-Filipino Conference. This is game day number 5. We have a triple header coming up. May isa pa tayong laban. Akari Chargers going up against the undefeated Cherry Tigo Crossovers. That's going to be an exciting one. And if you missed the first game, F2 beating NextLed, scoring their second win in the tournament so far. And that one is outside a break here for Farm Fresh. 9-13.
9 serving 13. Serving Louis Romero.
Must win third set for Farm Fresh. Good time service to have a service ace.
Yes. And actually, medyo uncharacteristic of Savannah Davidson because she has a good first ball. But that was a good serve there by Louis Romero.
That's a good confidence booster for Louis Romero. There's a chance here. Ay, blown. Sayang yon. That went over. Bertolano, binigyan na regalo tong si... O pinadali ang buhay ni Savannah Davidson.
Nakita na ni Savannah yun eh, na overball. So why not get it na para makuha na nila yung puntos because the defense of Foxes was not ready. Now they're up by 4 points ulit. Talking about PLDT.
At ito na partner, 18 points na si Davison. Gusto niya higitan yung kanyang 19 points from the game before today against Akari. Let's see if she will get there.
15 serving 10.
She's had a few aces. She's had three aces already. She's a scoring machine, Savvy Davison. Trisha Tubu. Oh, she scores.
Trisha Tubu.
Davison couldn't keep that ball in play. Must feel good for Trisha.
Now Coach Roderick Afford bringing in Fiola Ceballos for Savannah Davison.
Oh, good serve.
But pero the first ball
has to punta eh.
Royce Tubino.
And ay makita mo talaga napakahirap nung yung serve na yon.
Uh-oh.
Pero si Kat Arado is Kat Arado. She is the idol of many of the liberos that she plays against.
And a very steady libero.
Uh-oh.
She has a good ball and defense. Ang galing niya magbasa ng attackers sa kalaban.
Oh, maganda rin yun. It's a good first ball also on the side of Farm Fresh. Tubu trying to make up for that last play. Santiago with a put away. And she is now with double digits. Santiago with her 10th point there. And keeping Farm Fresh afloat. Four-point deficit for Farm Fresh in this must-win third set. Reyes again.
Mika Reyes.
Ang pinaplacing-placing lang ni Reyes.
Parang hindi siya nagbibigyan malalakas na palo for this game. Puro placement yung mga drop balls niya, yung mga points niya for this game.
And that's the veteran in you. Parang a point is a point is a point siguro sabi
yeah.
ni Mika. So kung makukuha sa lagay-lagay,
I mean, doon nahihirapan yung kalaban niya eh. Dahil feeling ko na pansin na niya na ang bagal ng depensa na pag mga drop ball itong Farm Fresh.
13 serving 17.
And the lucky break. There's another point for Trisha Tubu. It's still there within four.
Now serving for
PLDT.
Trisha.
Makalapit ang Farm Fresh.
Oh, good save.
Chance here for Farm Fresh. Good read by Royce. Bertolano from the back. That works out.
Good target there. Targeting zone one of PLDT.
And really a good choice there by Romero. I think that even for PLDT, that they see Eliza Bertolano from back row would have been the last thing that you would expect, diba? Ang daming options sa harap binigay kay Eliza Bertolano. That one too much for Lazo to save and Royce Tubino giving PLDT the 18th point.
Every time nakakuha ng puntos itong Farm Fresh, hindi sila nakakuha ng back-to-back points kasi nakakagawa kagad ng paraan yung PLDT.
Nakita natin sila mag-streak nung first set lang, partner. Hindi na nila naulit.
Kate Santiago,
scoring point number 11. Like the fight in Kate.
We
see how she has a never say die attitude. Lumiliit na ilamang.
Now substitution for PLDT. Michelle Morente is now inside the court, subbing in for Erica Santos. We know Michelle is a very high scorer. Opposite of PLDT during the previous conference.
Coming in quite late in this match.
Yeah. And now, 2 points na lang ang lamang nitong PLDT.
Safe serves. And we credit steady serving for Farm Fresh. Also PLDT. Hardly any service errors. Ceballos with a good save. She goes up for the hit. Kate Santiago's there.
Oh! Good defense by Michelle.
We like this rally. Moreto going up. Good
nice
save,
save
there. Look at Lazo with the acrobatics. Dimac looking for Ceballos.
Long rally.
Bertolano's timing it. Ceballos with a stop. Morente.
Oh,
and what a hard-earned point for Mitch Morente, who scores as soon as she comes in.
Right. After she delayed her attack, parang pababahan na siya kung kailan niya napalo yung bola na yon, targeting down the line. Take a look at this.
Talk about the focus. Ang tagal na nung rally at nakapag-isip pa talaga si Morente. Placed and timed her hit perfectly. That was an enjoyable rally, and really, Farm Fresh should be proud of themselves.
Service
pero ito naman
ang
service ace ni Mika Reyes na talagang nakaka... Talagang it's a downer for Farm Fresh dahil ang ganda ng pinakita nila, pero agad-agad umiscore si Mika. 7 points for Mika Reyes. Umarangkada talaga siya in this third set. Taneng.
And hindi nabanggit natin kanina na hindi masyadong madaming palo ang pinapakawalan nito ni Mika Reyes. But very smart at the drop balls and service aces. She already scored a couple of service aces for this game.
Now it's Palomata's turn to score. She was quiet so far in this third set. That's her 8th point.
After that long rally, parang medyo bumagal or bumitahan itong Farm Fresh Foxes kasi hindi na sila nagko-cover sa kanilang mga attacks.
Tubu, deadly from back row. That's what we want to see more of. Alam natin na kayang-kaya ni Trisha Tubu. She has that talent.
Parang minsan pinipigilan pa niya yung sarili niya, no? Medyo quiet pa. But she knows, and the whole team knows, that she is one of their top scorers, actually.
Ulitin nga natin sinabi mo for those just joining the coverage now. 29 points so far after 2 games, which
yes,
is more than her outing in the entire,
the entire conference, last conference. Because 26 points now for the entire conference yung natali niya. But coming into this conference in just 2 games, naka 29 points na siya. And more points pag ginad pa itong game nila ito.
Makarelax na si Trish Tubo kasi natapos na niya yung kanyang thesis defense. Again, kudos to you, Trisha Tubo, and all of the student players here in the PVL. Mitch Morente just continues to score. Tuloy-tuloy lang si Mitch. Pagkatapos ipasok ni Coach Rel dito sa ating third set. Everything she touches turns to gold, Mitch Morente.
That's actually a tough target, ha? As in, nasa dulo ng court, right in the corner pocket.
Libero change for PLDT entering the game number 9.
And I think what we're seeing here really, Paneng, is PLDT showing that they're going to be a force to reckon with in this second All-Filipino.
Coach Ral giving opportunities for the rest of his players to play for this game. Now bringing in their second setter, Ange Legacion, to subbing in for Rhea Lima.
18 serving 23.
PLDT still enjoying Romero. A 5-point lead, but here's a chance for Farm Fresh to score. We have a violation called again against Farm Fresh. Somebody at the net, I believe.
Football call.
And we are going to see a challenge from Farm Fresh. We haven't seen too many challenges.
I think this is the second challenge for this game.
Oo, but both from Farm Fresh, ano? Yeah. Hindi pa nag-challenge ang PLDT.
Hindi pa.
Because they're just doing quite well and easily and taking things, matters into their hands. So a footfall challenge saan, sa midline?
Yeah, sa midline. I think it was during the quick attack of Del Palomata. But the second referee called a net touch violation naman nung play na yon kay Tagsip.
See where we're at here. Parang well, si Tagsip yung
nag-footfall.
Or nakatapak pa rin siya sa line? Is that,
no.
Does that mean?
I think they were challenging na si Del Palomata yung
nag-footfall.
The challenge is successful. The point will be reclaimed.
Okay, we need to get some clarity there. I don't know if the playback really explained what happened. All we saw kasi talaga is si...
But there was no point naman. They replayed that last sequence.
So this is a break for Farm Fresh. At least they're able to hold PLDT at 23 points. Because nanganganib na rin sila. Ceballos tries to push the ball in. Tubu going up, winding up, and again, a little overblown there for Trisha Tubu. The precision, of course, Coach Jerry PLDT reminding Trisha to use her wrist a little bit more. No?
Match, Viola Ceballos.
A little more wrist action there for Trisha Tubu was needed. Keep the ball in zone.
Oh.
Oh, drop ball.
Oh, good Kate pancake Santiago. Save.
Ganda ng depensa din ni Kate Santiago. You gotta say, talagang she has been all around, really. For Farm Fresh, and they are doing a really good job.
Take a look at that save by Kate. And a good finish there by Bertolano.
5 points for Bertolano already. Let's see if she can hold match point with a jump serve. Another one. Ginawa niya ulit. Or match point. Try it the second time. I guess sabi niya, hindi naman nila isipin gagawin ko uli. Gawin ko nga uli.
Yeah. Lahat ng defense, nakaabang lang sa makaluin ni Del. But why not do that again? 1-2 play right in between a donut hole of Farm Fresh Poppies.
And that's how it ended. But this time, Farm Fresh scoring 20 points against 25 of PLDT. Once again, we live this game and all PBL games anytime, anywhere on the Pilipinas Live app. Available for Filipinos everywhere. Download.
Chiki Infaneng here with me is player of the game, Savvy Davison of the PLDT High Speed Hitters with 18 points, 13 attacks, 2 blocks, and 3 aces. Congratulations, Savvy. It's a double sweep on that. So I actually heard that your family has been supporting you with your stint here back home. So has your family been going crazy over this good news?
Yeah, actually I have family in Amsterdam watching. I have family here watching. I have family back at home in Canada watching, so hi guys, if you're watching, sending them all my love.
And you know what? Secondly, you've been adjusting pretty well to the team, so what do you think is the best quality of PLDT that you've showed in today's game?
I think the preparedness to come together. When things are going bad, you know, we've always found secureness within our team, within the core of the group, and I think that we really brought that back tonight. I think that, you know, whatever is going on, winning and losing, I think, you know, the confidence in himself and us and just knowing how we play, I think that's how, you know, we're doing it and how we finished.
And exactly, you're actually talking about how they made you feel at home. So now, do you want to greet your friends, your family?
Hi, I'm not sure where you guys are watching, but I'm sending all my love and prayers. God bless. Thank you so much for my support.
Thank you again, Savvy, and congratulations to the rest of the PLDT High Speed Hitters. More volleyball action ahead, so stay tuned.
Thanks so much, Ai, and congratulations to our player of the game. Well-deserved itong si Savvy Davison. And very charming siya, no? I'm sure na po yung mga fans niya, dadami pa yan through the days here. And let's take a look at the highlights of this game.
Well, definitely a good start to finish itong PLDT High Speed Hitters. They had a good defense. We always say that good defense, floor defense, net defense. But they stayed very relaxed and composed all throughout the game. Kahit na lumalamang yung, kahit na malaking lamang nila and konti-konting lumalapit ang puntos nitong Far Fresh Foxes. But they stick to their game plan. Basic volleyball, we didn't see a lot of combination plays from their side, but they were still able to get a lot of points from their attacks. And kudos also to their libero, si Kat Arado, who scored the point kanina sa kanyang over-receive. So that just shows how smart overall and veteran itong PLDT squad. And for the side of the Farm Fresh Foxes, there are a lot of opportunities na kaya nilang dumipensa, but yung push, yung nakulangan doon sa kanila, na yung aggressiveness to start sa first ball and defense to get more transition plays, yung nagkulang, as well as their combination and their intensity for this game.
Mm-hmm. A lot of bright spots actually we saw on the side of Farm Fresh. Nung nagagawa nila yung mga combination attacks, it really works like a charm. Maganda yung execution. They just need more opportunities like you mentioned.
Right. And now we're looking at the match statistics. PLDT dominating on the attack department with 45 versus 36 ng Foxes. And 7 block points and 7 aces for the High Speed Hitters.
Wow.
Versus 3 block points ng Foxes. Halos same lang itong errors, because 1 point lang yung difference ng Foxes with 16 errors and 15 ng PLDTs. But PLDT, tremendous job on that attack, blocking and service department for their squad.
PLDT just proving really that they are a force to reckon with. They lost that first game that they played against Signal, but they are showing how Davison has worked well into the system of PLDT, and we are looking forward to seeing more of her and the rest of the team here at the PBL. We got one more game. Akari getting ready to face Cherry Tigo for our third and final game today. On behalf of Paneng Deconics Water, Alexis Tinsay, Marvin Chavez, our director. This has been Chikiro Puno. Thanks for joining us. Stay tuned for more volleyball after this.
This conference, we can finally see as a team. Kung saan kami makakapunta, we believe na everything will fall into place.
I also ponder, ano kaya? Okay.